Hi everyone, this is Emmy. Today I'm going to show you how you can crochet a motif for a necklace. So let's get started. Today I'm going to work with worsted cotton and a 4.5 millimeter crochet hook. Start with a slip knot, chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is a time when you do want to have tight work. Slip stitch to join in that very first stitch, and that will form a ring. This motif is a combination of chain 8, chain 5, chain 8, chain 5. So I'm going to start with chain 8. And to chain, you simply pick up the yarn and pull it through. That's a chain. So I'm going to do 7 more because I need 8. Single crochet in the ring. Chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Single crochet in the ring. And I'm carrying the yarn end along the outside of the ring because that will be one less yarn end to have to weave in. So I'm going to do chain 8, single crochet in the ring, chain 5, single crochet in the ring. I'm going to continue around. And I'm going to make my last single crochet in the ring. Then I'm going to slip stitch to join in the base of that first chain 8. Fasten off. And that's what the motif will look like. Chain 8, chain 5, 8, 5, 8, 5, 8, and 5. And then I attached a silver bead to each of these bottom loops, but you could also sew those on. And since this is cotton worsted, it's quite thick. So on this end, all I did was form a loop with a knot. And then to make the closure, I'm going to thread a bead on. And then I'm going to make one knot. But I want this to be really big so that the bead doesn't fall off. So I'm just going to make a second knot right there so that I have a nice big knot. And then this bead won't fall off. Trim off that little extra. And I'm going to make one more knot just on the other side of the bead, just to hold it so that it doesn't go sliding down the cord like that. So now is my buttonhole. I can button that on like that. Trim off that little extra. Now to attach my cord to the motif, I'm just going to find the center. I'm going to pass it through this loop. And then I'm going to bring the other ends through the loop, like that. Then to make this motif nice and rigid, I'm just going to take some Elmer's glue, and I have diluted it into another bottle with water, and I'm going to just go ahead and apply that all over. And let it absorb from the other side as well. And then I'm just going to allow that to dry. And I added one more bead in the center. And so here it is on just one strand of cotton worsted. And if you'd like to make a heavy chain like this, you can refer to my video on making chains for hanging your jewelry. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.